Listen, I've been hearing a lot of stuff on Twitter and on Facebook about people wanting to support law enforcement because there's so many of them being killed right now. Listen, I think it's a great idea, and it inspires me that citizens in our country want to do that. But let me tell you how you should do it. Don't approach the law enforcement officers. Just like you would when you're on the playground with your kids or you're dropping them off at school. Listen, be aware of your surroundings. And when you see a cop getting gas or you see a cop getting coffee or having lunch with a partner, listen, just look around and see what's normal and what's not. If you see something imminent, then you approach the officer. If you see something strange, call 911. If you feel the need to approach the officer at that point, that's fine. But don't just walk up to officers and say, hey, buddy, I got your six, or hey, listen, I'm watching out for you. Listen, that's strange, and it's going to set alarms off with law enforcement. And when you're trying to watch their backs, that's not what you need to do. Cops don't need to be inspired. They need to be looked out for right now in this day and age. And listen, for all the law enforcement out there, I used to be one of you, right? I love all you guys. But let me give you a little piece of advice. A smile goes a long ways. My good buddy, who's a sergeant on a police department, told me a long time ago when I was in the FBI that nothing goes further than a smile and a calm attitude when dealing with the public. You don't have to be the tactical guru all the time, and you can be just as aware why you're nice. And look, there's no doubt that there's a lot of people out there that don't like cops right now, but you don't need to approach every single person as though they're the person that hates you. Be the tactical guy or girl, and also be nice. It goes a long ways, and right now, you may not realize it, but there's people out there that have your back. I'm one of them. They're all over Twitter. People are all over this country rallying for you. It's just that they work during the day, or you know, they don't go out, you know, protesting in the evenings. They're good law-abiding citizens, and they're not making a fuss. Because here's the deal. I love all of you. Police officers, veterans, our citizens, doctors, nurses. I love everybody. Truck drivers, love truck drivers. And here's the thing. We, the people, we're the ones who are going to save this country. These criminals in D.C., they're not doing anything. National security is a joke. Foreign policy is a disaster. Nobody has done anything about this racial divide in this country but make it worse as far as politicians go. And now people are killing the cops. What the hell's going on in this country? I'll tell you what's going on. We have no leadership. We depend on two parties that are broken, the Republican and the Democratic parties. They're a joke now. So here's what we need to do. Come together as a people. We the people. That's what we were founded on. We the people, that's what the Constitution says. We should be the government. So here's what we have to do. Forget about those people up in Washington, D.C. Even some of the local governments are completely screwed up. I'm not calling for anarchy. What I'm talking about is supporting each other. Law enforcement and civilians. Let's start with that. Let's watch each other's backs. Let's put a smile on. Let's let each other know that we are looking out for each other. That's what we do here. You don't have to put on a uniform in order to support and serve. That's ridiculous. You just have to wake up and say, I'm going to be the best person I can, and I'm going to earn my citizenship today.